Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and in today's video I'm going to be sharing with you all some really amazing lipsticks which I found in the year 2020. So the first lipstick is the K Beauty Matte Lipstick in the shade Rolling. Now this one has to be my favorite. It is a beautiful deep maroon color, and the best part about this is I feel it will suit every Indian skin tone, be it fair or dusky. I think this shade will look gorgeous on everyone. And what do I even say about the formula? It's amazing. Being the darkest shade in the range, I was stunned by its pigmentation. It's beautiful, it's matte, it's comfortable, and the staying power is great too. All in all, I really like it. So next I have the MAC Retro Matte Lip Color in the shade Topped with Brandy. Now this is a very uncommon shade that I found this year, and if I have to describe it, I would say it's more like a cool tone, dirty mauve sort of a color. And again, this is a kind of shade which will suit most of us, and it's a very beautiful, unique lipstick with a very comfortable formula and a very good pigmentation and very good longevity. And all in all, I feel it's a beautiful lipstick and I really love wearing it. So the next lipstick that I have here is from Faces, and it is in the shade Wild Orchid. And you know, I have got so many DMs regarding purple lipstick recommendations. Surprisingly, a lot of you guys love purple lipsticks, right? So I just thought of mentioning this one because I think this is the only purple shade I wore throughout the year 2020, and I love this shade. The formula and everything is amazing. In fact, I love this range. I have two more lipsticks from this range in this video itself. The formula is comfortable, it's matte, and it looks gorgeous. So next I have a lipstick from MAC. It is from the Powder Kiss Liquid Lip Color range, and the shade is Mullet Over. I think this collection was launched in July 2020 or something, because I know this is a new collection, and the formula of this lipstick is actually extremely comfortable. It has a sort of like a velvet mousse texture, and this shade in particular is a beautiful coral nude lipstick for me. And I feel that this shade will suit fair to medium skin tones, because whenever I don't wear foundation now, this shade washes me out, because I do have a little bit of pigmentation around my mouth. So I feel this shade will not suit dusky or deep skin tones. I think this is particularly made for fair to medium skin tones. I do have a medium skin tone, and without foundation this shade washes me out. So yeah, I just wanted to tell you that. And it's a beautiful shade though, I really like it. Whenever I feel like wearing coral nude lipstick, I go for this. Next we have a red lipstick here, and this one is from NYX, and it is from their Line and Load Lippy collection in the shade Biker Babe. Now this is one red lipstick which really stood out to me this year. So whenever I wear this shade, I don't know, it just really makes me stand out. I mean, normally red lipsticks do that, but trust me, this one is quite unique. Maybe it's the formula, I don't really know, because the formula is sort of like a mousse and it has a matte texture, but it's very pigmented. And sometimes I like to use it on its own, or sometimes what I do is I top it up with some other red lipstick underneath. In both ways, it just looks stunning and it's a beautiful red lipstick. Moving on, next I have another lipstick from Faces, and it is in the shade Espresso. Now if you are looking for a true brown color, I think you can go for this. So the formula and everything is again very comfortable, it's matte, it's beautiful. I actually love one more brown shade. It is the shade Chai from Nykaa. It's another favorite brown of mine. I have mentioned it in my nude lipsticks video, but the thing is, Chai has some red undertones to it, whereas this one is like a true perfect brown color. Even my mom loves it, and for the matter of fact, I think this is one brown shade which I have used the most in the year 2020. And yeah, it's a beautiful brown and I really like it. Now the next lipstick can be a little scary. So this is again from Faces, and it is in the shade Nutshell. Now this shade can be very subjective, because it's definitely more grungy out of all of these shades, and I understand that it's very bold, but I find this shade very unique. And I know some people really love these kind of like grungy gothic shades, and if I had to describe this color, I would say it's like a dark brownish grayish shade and also initially this shade came off a little patchy, but after using it for a few times the top layer was off and it felt quite smooth. Still, I think you have to apply it twice to get the opaque pigmentation, but I mentioned it because it's a very very different shade and I really find it very unique. So next I have the shade Stepping Out from Smashbox, and I have already talked about this in my new lipsticks video, so I was thinking not to mention it, but honestly it would have been so unfair since this is one of those lipsticks which I have used the most in the year 2020. And it's a very unique shade, to be honest. It's a very unique nude lipstick. I really love the tones of it. It has these cool brown undertones to it and it just looks stunning. And I do use it on its own, but what I do more often is I apply a dark shade underneath and I top it up with this lipstick, and it just makes every shade look so beautiful. And I think it is one of those lipsticks which I carry everywhere every single time. It's my absolute favorite and I need it every freaking time. So the last lipstick that I have here is from Rimmel and it is in the shade Urban Affair. Now this shade is like a berry tone mauve color and I really love wearing this shade. Like, there was this phase of mine in the year 2020, I think around November, where this was the only lipstick which I was wearing every single time, and I really like this shade as well. Like, I like it a lot. And talking about the formula, the texture is creamy but it dries down matte, and the longevity is great too, but I feel like for the people with dry lips, it can be a bit drying. So do moisturize your lips beforehand, and it's a beautiful lipstick. So yeah, that's it for today. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video and found it helpful. If you did, then please hit the like button and please take a moment and subscribe to my channel. It would mean so much to me. And also take good care of yourself wherever you are, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.